ESA's Solar Orbiter and NASA's Parker Solar Probe are space weather sidekicks on two separate but complementary missions to study our star, with the aim of being able to better predict when solar wind might pose risks to our communication satellites, electrical grid, and even astronauts. Professor Susan Lepre is Solar Orbiter's Heavy Ion Sensor Deputy Principal Investigator. Her team is in charge of an instrument that will analyze trace elements in the solar wind, determining its risk to technology in orbit and on the ground. Professor Justin Casper is principal investigator for Parker's SWEEP investigation, which measures the solar wind at extreme proximity to the sun. Solar Orbiter is scheduled to launch from Cape Canaveral, Florida on February 5, 2020, aboard an Atlas V rocket. Parker launched a year and a half ago on August 12, 2018 from Cape Canaveral aboard a Delta IV Heavy rocket. Orbiter is a bigger satellite with a launch mass of 3,968 pounds and will have an 18-meter solar panel wingspan. In comparison, Parker's launch mass was 1,510 pounds, and it's about 9 feet 10 inches long. Orbiter's bigger body is packed with an array of 10 primary scientific instruments, while Parker's payload carries 4 instrument suites. Parker had to be a lot lighter in order for its orbit to dip so close to the sun, and it can't carry the same kind of hardware because of the extreme heat. For example, unlike Orbiter, Parker has no cameras that view the sun directly. No current technology could look at the sun from that close and survive. If Earth were scaled down to sit at one end of a football field and the sun at the other, Parker would make it to the 4-yard line. Solar Orbiter will come within the 27-yard line, which is still the second closest approach of all time. Where Parker collects up-close ground truth samples, Orbiter is further back and able to use its cameras in conjunction with other sensors to localize its samples to where they originated on the sun. In other words, it can say this solar wind has these qualities and it came from a solar flare that happened on this region of the sun. And at key moments, both Orbiter and Parker's orbits align so that they can do measurements on the same gusts of solar weather at different points downstream. This is important because those comparisons will show how the weather changes as it gets further away from the sun. Another key differentiator is that Orbiter will follow a highly tilted orbit and provide our first ever direct images of the sun's poles, allowing scientists to see how the structure and behavior of the solar wind varies at different latitudes. So here's a heliospheric high five to both missions as they work together to help humanity become a spacefaring species.